Hello, dear friends. In the sixth lecture on Erasmus Ecclesiastical Law, we continue our topic on church and state relations in modern Europe. And now we enter into the subsystems of multi-denominational state, which constitute a group of the system of separation. Subsystems of multi-denominational states may expressly recognize one or more religions at a constitutional level or at a general legislative level, or may not recognize them at all. States which expressly recognize one or more religions at the constitutional level are Cyprus, Italy, Spain, Poland, and Lithuania. States which expressly recognize one or more religions and, at a general legislative level is Israel. I have to note that the subsystems of multi-denominational states prevail in Europe today. The absolute majority of church and state systems in Europe belong to these subsystems of multi-denominational state. Multi-denominational state system constitute a subgroup of separation system in which there is a relative equality of religions, and simultaneously an extensive cooperation of a state with some religions, only some religions. Extensive cooperation of a state with some religions means that a state gives prerogatives, gives privileges, that is, religious rights beyond religious rights recognized by the international law or the constitutional law, only to some religions. In such subsystems, church-state relations are regulated by legislation or conventions. Agreements these states have with Holy See fall within international law because only Holy See has public international law personality, while all other ecclesiastical conventions are in the domain of internal law and in the legal theory. Other scholars support that those ecclesiastical conventions belong to public law domain, while other scholars support that those ecclesiastical conventions belong to a mixed domain. The countries where these subsystems apply generally accept the principles of church-state separation, first. Second, of the state's multi-denominational nature. Third, of graduated equality through the differentiation of the legal regimes of the various creeds, that is, the relative equality of religions. Fourth, of the benevolent neutrality of the state. And fifth, of church autonomy. Belgium, moreover, institutionally protects the religious freedom of those who hold no religious beliefs. The graduated equality of religious groups is predicated on the idea that differential treatment does not constitute religious discriminations. If it is based on objective and reasonable grounds, in each case, and refers only to social and non-religious differences. That is, in the multi-denominational state subsystems, there is a relative equality of religion, as I have said already, and this means that this equality is justified only on sociological reasons and not on religious reasons. For example, as it concerns the privilege of the religious agents in the army, what religion could cooperate with the state in the religious agents in the army? In Greece, the Orthodox Church. In Italy, the Catholic Church. And for what reason? Because Orthodox Church in Greece is considered socially predominant, or Catholic Church is considered in Italy as socially predominant. This is a sociological criterion which in the context of this multi-denominational state subsystems permit a legal differentiation of treatment between a socially predominant religion and the other religions in the same state territory. In the United States, the religious agency in the army is a multi-denominational one, because from the sociological point of view, there is not any prevailing religion. Under Portugal's religious freedom law of 2000, the privileges granted to the Catholic Church in the Concordat of 1940 were extended to other registered religious communities in the interest of religious freedom. That means that Portugal is the only country in Europe in which extends the privileges accorded to the Catholic Church in Portugal, which is a socially predominant religion in Portugal, to other churches or religious communities through the legislative technique of the law on religious freedom of 2000. There is a distinction between registered and non-registered religious organizations. Austria, Czech Republic, Hungary, Italy, Latvia, Lithuania, Poland, Portugal, Slovak Republic, Slovenia, Spain and Ukraine have laws for the registration of creeds. This distinction is found in virtually all countries having these subsystems. Its consequences are not limited to the right of association of religious groups, but are related to the concession of religious rights and privileges. The distinction between registered and non-registered religious organizations is a real one, not only in the subsystems of multi-denominational state, but in any system of church and state. And then, as it is known, well known, from the international human rights standards, there must not be any differentiation in the enjoyment of the religious human rights recognized by the international and constitutional law. But in practice, the unregistered churches or religious communities have not the same status as it concerns the enjoyment of religious human rights recognized by the international law and constitution, not speaking about privileges accorded by the state. Because for a range of religious rights, practically is required a registration, that is, the acquisition of the legal personality according to the state law. For example, to open bank accounts, to rent buildings, to buy buildings, is practically required for them, for the church or religious communities, to have legal personality. Otherwise, there are disadvantages for them. Because if a religious group has not a legal personality, then it can acquire rights in the name of natural persons. And this is very dangerous because the acquisition of those rights can be questioned by the successors of the persons who acquired those rights in the name, in their name, but in fact, on behalf of their religious groups. A second distinction arises from the establishment of multi-tier structures for the legal regime of religious communities. Such multi-tier structures are based on the legal character of public or private law, sui generis in Germany, official recognition in Austria or Belgium, and the historic in Hungary or traditional character in Latvia of particular churches or religious communities. This means that there is another distinction of a different treatment of churches of religious communities resulting from the establishment of multi-tiered structures of legal regimes for religious communities. In Germany, there is the differentiation between public and private law churches or religious communities, but all of them are of sui generis. Public law churches or religious communities sui generis, private law churches or religious communities sui generis. Sui generis means that either the public law or the private law churches or religious communities enjoy the right to autonomy. That is, not only the private law churches or religious communities have the right to legislate by themselves for their internal affairs, but also the public law churches or religious communities have the same right to, that is, to legislate for their internal affairs, that is, to enact their statutes. Public law corporations in Germany, in all the Länder, that is, in all the federate states of the Federation of Germany, 16 federate states, in all the 16 federate states, are a Catholic Church and the Evangelical Lutheran Church. Other churches or these communities can have this public law status in some only federate states and private law status in other federate states, as the Orthodox Church of Germany has public law status in Bavaria and private law status in other federate states of the Federation of Germany. Official recognition is a criterion of differentiation of treatment of churches and religious communities. In Austria or Belgium, official recognition through special laws. The historic character of churches and religious communities is a criterion of differentiation of treatment in Hungary. The traditional character of churches and religious communities is a criterion for differentiation of church and religious communities in Latvia. The status of churches or religious communities with agreements with the state is another criterion for differentiation of treatments between churches and religious communities. As for example, in Italy or in Spain. In a recent law of 1997, so recent, Austria introduced the regime of registered religious confessional communities, intermediate between the recognized and non-recognized religious communities. The Czech Republic and Latvia have patterned their regimes after the Austrian model. As it is known in Austria, there are the recognized by law, special laws, and non-recognized religious communities. From 1997, there is another also, another type of churches or religious communities. Register religious confessional communities. And Czech Republic and Latvia have as their model for their national laws the model of Austria. Official recognition of religious communities in Austria, Belgium, and Lithuania is established by law. This is incongruous with the quality of creeds, because some creeds have no right to official recognition. Despite meeting the requirements prescribed by law in Austria, Lithuania, or developed through administrative and legislative practice in Belgium. And the existence of official recognition of religious communities in Austria, Belgium, and Lithuania is incongruous with equality of creeds, as those countries have not established criteria, preconditions for a right of the other church or religious communities to gain an access to a superior status, that is, of the official recognition, if they accomplish those eventual requirements. Similarly, unequal access to enhanced religious freedom exists in other countries as well, by means of selective agreements between the government and religious communities. In Italy, Portugal, Spain, and Poland. In contrast, Germany provides for the right of religious organizations to acquire the status of public law corporations. Unequal access, that is, there is not an access to a superior status. Through concluding agreements with the government, contrary to the discrimination exists in some countries, Portugal, Italy, Spain, Poland. But as it concerns Poland, there is no, as it concerns Portugal, there is not a serious omission, because there is a law, each law of 2000 on religious freedom, which grants the privileges accorded to Catholic Church, to the other church religious communities. So, the governments of those countries have an unlimited power, that is, a power without preconditions provided by the law, to select the religions, church religious communities, with which to conclude agreements for mutual regulation of their relations, and so for passing to that superior religion state. In Germany, there are preconditions for passing from the inferior status of private law organizations to public law corporations. One very known precondition was the obeisance to the state. Which, after a recourse to the Constitutional Court of Germany by the Witnesses of Jehovah's, who wanted to pass to the superior status of public law corporations, the Constitutional Court of Germany judged that this precondition for passing to that superior status for religions is contrary to the German Constitution, that is the obeisance, that is to obey to the state. But it is in conformity with the German Constitution to provide a precondition for the churches or religious communities for passing to the superior status of public law corporations. To obey not to the state but to the law. Now we have finished the sixth lecture of Erasmus Ecclesiastical Law. Thank you for your attention.